So today we will see how we can create an event listener using a ref. So generally to add an event listener to a React element, we can add an onClick or onFocus, something like that, to the tag itself. But there is another way using hooks. So let us try creating one such hook. So I'm going to call this useOnClick. Okay, so now useOnClick. So what this function should do is it should take in a ref, or let's say let's just create the ref here. So something like const ref equals use ref. And we need to add an event listener to it. So we have seen in the last video that once the ref has been pointed to a DOM node, we can use an effect to add an event listener. So something like this. So a use effect, and here we need to add and remove event listeners. So useOnClick will take in a callback. So you want to listen to the click event and then react to it as a user. So you want to pass in a callback, and over here you want to add the callback. So how do we do it? As we have seen in the previous few videos, what happens is that when you add an event listener using document.addEventListener and so on, what happens is you create a closure. So we'll need to make sure that we point a reference to the global event listener queue in such a way that we always have the right state values within our callback. So to do that, the first thing we need to do is we need to track the callback. So const callback ref is another use ref that tracks this callback. And each time, after each render, we want to update the callback ref dot current to the new callback. So what actually happens is the useOnClick, this function runs each time the component that is using the hook re-renders. So each time this callback function is passed as an argument to useOnClick. So it could either be the same callback function or it might have updated. But we want to make sure that it's always the updated version. So callback ref.current equals callback. We'll make sure that a callback ref object always maintains the newest callback function. So we only need this when we are creating a closure, and that happens when we are returning a function to an outside scope or when we are adding an event listener. So now that that is done, so we only want to add event listener once. So I'm going to say document.addEventListener click. And here we need to pass in the handler function. Let's create that. So function handler, and all it does is it takes the event and calls callback ref.current. Since this is a function, which is nothing but the newest callback that was created. So callback ref.current of E. Okay, and now we have passed this to document.addEventListener. So we could either check if e.target is ref.current, or we could, instead of saying document.addEventListener, we could say ref. So since ref is pointing to the DOM node, we could say ref.current. And it will only point to the DOM node if we pass the ref as a return value. So we need to return the ref. So when the component is using it, it would use it something like this. Const ref equals useOnClick. And within its element, it would say h1 ref equals ref. So now our onClick hook will track this h1 element since the ref is pointing to it. Okay, so we have added the event listener, we have passed in the handler. The next thing is we also want to clean up the handler. So useEffect has a cleanup phase. So within that, we say ref.current.removeEventListener. Click handler. Okay. So this should do the job, I think. So now let's go back to index.js, and here I've imported the function, and here I'll say const ref equals useOnClick, and oh, it takes a function, right? So function handleClick. I don't need the event yet, so I'll just say console.log. App is clicked. Okay, and the next thing I'll do is I'll pass in the handle click to use on click. Oh wait, ref.current is not defined. Why is that? Oh yeah, I didn't pass it. I didn't give it to anything, right? So ref equals ref. So now let us see if that works. I'm going to open the console and click on this. Yep, it works. So let's do a small recap. So what we are doing here is we have created a hook that takes in a callback and returns a ref. And within that hook, what we have done is we have created a use effect that will add an event listener for a click event and run the callback whenever the click happens. And we are doing that by using a combination of refs and effects. So while this might not be always required, you can always add an event listener for something as basic as click or focus by using elements. This is very handy when you want to make a hook that will track an outside click. So there is no event listener for something like on outside click, right? That's not a default event. So you can create all sorts of hooks when you have flexibility. You can track all kinds of events. So outside click is a very unique event where when you click on an element, sometimes you show up a model or a pop-up and you want to make sure that when there's a click outside it, you want to close it. So these sort of behaviors are not exactly like clicks. So for making these, adding event listeners through refs are very handy. So in the next video, we'll see how we can do that.